Welcome to Sunny Day Stamping. I'm Julie Baca. Today's card, we're going to just be using stamps, ink, and paper. These are some of my favorite cards because they are usually very simple and quick to make. And I can really relate to that because I am very simple and I am like, go, 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 quick, quick. That's kind of like my personality. So I love these cards, but sometimes it's hard to make them like look wow because you feel like you need to emboss this or die cut that to make it or add embellishments. But I've just got a simple tip to make it just kind of pop out. I also have some color combination ideas for you too. So we'll get started on that. But first, if it's February 2023 when you're watching this video, this is Sailabration. It's one of Stampin' Up's biggest promotions where you can pick something free out of their Sailabration products with every $50 purchase. So if you spend $100, you get to pick two things or a larger item. They also added a bunch of things from the catalog to that freebie list. So you can go check that out on my website, sunnydaystamping.com. Now, all the measurements for this project are over on my website, as well as the supply list. You can purchase supplies right from there also. So, all right, let's get started. Stamps, ink, and paper is all you need for this card, with the exception of Stampin' Dimensionals if you want to use them, but that really is optional. So pick a great stamp set. This is one that is wonderful for just simple stamping. I think this is a great beginner stamp set. If you are a beginner or if you are a veteran stamper, this one comes with a die set that cuts all these out and a great label, and actually a wreath. So I've got other cards that I've made with this. Now, it comes with some beautiful sentiments too, but I'm going to use the happy labels for the inside of my card, but this would be optional. So when you are choosing your colors, this, I said I have one main way to make this pop, but really I've got four tips for you. And the first one is your color. You want to pick one main color that is just gonna be like, wow, just pick a bold color. And I've got some other combos to show you later in the video. And then for the cardstock, I had this one match. What's awesome about Stampin' Up, their inks and their cardstock match perfectly. So when you put a card together, it's going to look awesome. Sometimes when you buy from other stores, which is what I've been doing for years before I got into Stampin' Up, one red ink is not going to match their red paper, and that just frustrates me. So anyway, that is one reason why I love Stampin' Up. Okay, and then you're going to need three pieces, and these are all different sizes. I'm using very vanilla for this card, but in some of my other examples, I use white. Now, all the measurements for these papers are over on my website with the corresponding blog post, and there's going to be a lot of pictures over there to give you some ideas. Also, if for my email subscribers, they'll be getting this print and make project sheet, which has the measurements right on here, the instructions, and the list of supplies here. So if you'd like to get that, you can sign up for my email. So for this card, we're going to start with this really awesome, huge, nice, bold foliage stamp. And I'm going to ink it up in soft succulent. And actually, I said there were four things. Now I thought of another. A fifth tip for making simple stamping cards is, don't just put the whole image on your card. Have it come off your paper. I think that makes it look so, so interesting. And we'll do the same on this side. Actually, I'm going to actually just rotate this because I did kind of a less of the image that I wanted. So I'm going to put that in that corner and I'm going to show more of it down here because I don't want it to be completely symmetrical. Now you're going to take another piece of foliage from that stamp set and ink that up in your bold, your really bold color. And just pop that on there. Doesn't that just make it pop out? And you can see I'm doing less of it up here because I don't want it to be too matchy. Now grab a sentiment out of that stamp set or other ones. Use your other stamp sets to get save just the right thing that you want. And I'm just going to stamp this down here. You know what? I'm not so confident that I inked that up all the way. So sometimes, especially with this black ink pad, it's smaller. You can see that it's smaller than the other ink pads. Sometimes I like to just turn it over and tap it onto my stamp to make sure I got it on there really well. Now, if you stamp yours differently than mine, you may want your sentiment up here. So find out where is the largest, like, empty spot on this card and put your sentiment there. So really, there's no really right or wrong way to do this. Just kind of go with it and have fun with it. And you know what? If you don't like how it turns out, flip that piece of paper over and start again. You got two chances on this, or cut a whole nother piece. So this is it for the front of our card. That's done. Look how fast. Now you're going to take your largest piece of very vanilla or white, if you're using that, and we are going to, this is for the inside of our card. So I'm going to take another piece of foliage. So there are, in that stamp set, there are three gorgeous pieces of foliage and one flower. So I'm going to stamp that in full strength ink. Then I'm going to stamp another one in full strength, but this time I'm going to stamp it off on my paper just so it has a different tone. You can see that these are darker and that's lighter, so it almost looks like a different color. Then I grabbed a stamp out of that Happy Labels because I wanted something for the inside. And we'll just put it, oh my goodness. Sorry, I made you guys dizzy. Let me Oh, that's my problem. I'm lining it up with my paper and my paper is askew. Oh my gosh. Okay, there we go. All right, we're gonna pop this on there. All right, we've got that done. We'll set that aside. Now you're going to grab one more thing. You're gonna grab your card base. But before we add things on there, I love to stamp on the back of my card. And I think that is my third or fourth tip. I can't remember now that I added more. I'm gonna change this. I love to stamp on the back of my card. I think it just gives it that extra so awesomeness. We're gonna put a flower. I was gonna do it in the same color, but I actually want this to pop out a little more. So I'm gonna put just this beautiful flower here. So now I think we've used all the pieces, but I'm going to grab this splotch. This is kind of like a sun splotch or like a paint splatter or something. And it is just so versatile. I'm going to ink this up in the rich Razzleberry, which is going to match my cardstock. And I'm just going to stamp it here. And then I'm going to stamp it again here. So it's going to be darker and lighter. All right, now we're going to glue everything together. Actually, no. I am going to clear my workspace because I'm going to get ink on all my beautiful stamping and I don't want to have to restart. All right, now we're ready. Just going to put some glue on the back of here. All right, this last tip. No, I got one more. But anyway, my main tip that I wanted to show you was to make your simple stamping pop out of your card. Oh no, look, I got some smudge on there. Okay, we're gonna try this trick. I saw another demonstrator do this. She got a mono sand eraser and said that it would take off ink spots. Let's see if this works. Oh wow. Oh my goodness. I think it's working. I'm not rubbing really hard. I'm just kind of rubbing in a circle. It's not coming all the way out, but wow, that really saved this card. Let's see if this little mark will come off. No. Okay, that's good. Okay, back to my tip. So this looks good, but I think it just really makes it wow and elegant to put a piece of the same color down and then your stamped image on top. Do you see how it gives a just a very subtle like frame? So you don't even know why you like it at first because it's that same color. I just think this makes it look so cool. So let's glue this white piece down. Now you can glue this right on top of there, or my final tip is pop this thing up with dimensionals. It's gonna create a little shadow around it, which also just sets it off. And this gives a literal pop to your card because these are raised. I don't know if you can see this. They're just add a little thickness to pop that up off of your card. One more tip. When you get down to the bottom of your dimensionals, the edge of this, don't throw this away, man. You can use that. It's all the same material. So one last thing before you go. I thought of another tip, so I gotta do my math again. So I think this is 6. Stamp your envelope. Even if it's just one little stamp on the back, it's gonna just really make it look awesome. So let me just give you a closer look. You can see how those Stampin' Dimensionals just pop that up. Can you see the shadow? I just think that looks so elegant and awesome. What an awesome set. Let me show you some of these other color combinations. Now for this card, I used old olive, but my pop of color is black. And these are all from those same stamp sets. All from these same two, Nature's Prints, and then I threw some happy labels for the inside. Now this one, I used white as my background. I don't know how you feel about this, but I wanted to kind of go a little bit crazy with the color. So the black in this one is actually my like regular color, but my splotch of color is Coastal Cabana. So I kind of like that. I don't know. Let me know how you feel about these kind of crazy colors. One more. I am like addicted to Pool Party and Real Red together. So there is that one. Oh, I forgot to show you the back of the cards. I just think that's so cool. Okay. I didn't put anything on the black, but let's see. Where's that old olive one? Yeah. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. You can also click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next video. If you really love paper crafting and you actually shop a lot for paper craft products, you might want to consider joining Stampin' Up. Especially during Celebration, they've got this crazy awesome promotion for the starter kit. You get to choose $175 worth of products for $99. So honestly, if your wish list is longer than $99, really consider joining. You can join just for the discount. You can be your only customer. And I would love to have you on my team. There are so many benefits. I'm actually part of Jackie Bullheist at Klompen Stampers, her team. She's the one who's putting out all those Funfold template videos. When you are on her team, you get those videos for free, as well as access to her crafting community. So if you join through me, you would also be part of her team. So if you have any questions, leave me a comment or reach out to me. I'd love to help you decide if this is the right fit for you. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Have a sunny day.